Hello students, today we are going to discuss about house rental loans. In the previous classes, we have discussed few exemptions under section 10 like agricultural income, share of profit from partnership firm, share of profit from HF, commutation of pension, gratuity and so on. Today we have to discuss about house rent allowance. Because house rent allowance is exempt under section 10 subsection 13A. First, we have to discuss what do you mean by house rent allowance. In short, it is HRA. House rent allowance is nothing but it's an allowance paid by the employer to his employee to meet the expenditure to be incurred on payment of rent for residential accommodation of the employee. That's it. Very simple. House rent allowance is an allowance paid by the employer to his employee to meet high rental value of residential accommodation in cities of a particular employee. Because employee is working at a place where he is sometimes does not have a house property, that's what he has to pay rented. To meet such kind of expenditure, allowance will be given by the employer. This is included in the salary, but entire amount is not included in the salary because section 10 subsection 13A allows certain amount of exemption of a particular HRA. Then what is exempted, how much exempted? In this case, irrespective whether the employee is government employee or non-government employee, certain conditions are there. If certain conditions are satisfied, then certain amount of HRA is exempted and remaining amount is included in the income of salary of an employee during the previous year. Let us have a look on how much is exempted and how it is exempted. Out of the HRA, house rent allowance is received by the employee, the least of the following things are exempted. Here there are 3 points are there. We will get 3 amount. Out of these 3 amount, any amount which is least out of 3, that is exempted and remaining amount is taxable. This exemption is under section 10 subsection 13A. First one is actual HRA. How much of HRA paid by the employer to the employee? That is first amount. Second amount, excess of rent paid by the employee over 10% of his salary during the previous year. Second point is very important because at the time of residing in a rented house, he has to pay rent. In connection with how much rent and how much salary, we have to calculate second point. That's what. Second point is how much of rent paid, which is excess in connection with 10% of salary. I will tell you later about how much salary or what do you mean by salary for this purpose. And third one, 50% of salary or 40% of salary. The two categories are there here. Then how it is 50% and how it is 40% or when it is 40%, when it is 50%. Very simple. 50% in case where an employee is resided in a cities like metropolitan cities like Chennai, Delhi, Calcutta and Mumbai. If an employee working in these 4 cities, so we have to take third one is 50% of salary. In other cities, 40% of salary has to be taken. So, this is 3 items. Out of these 3 items, which is least amount, that is exempted. Certain conditions are there. Who will claim exemption? Who is not eligible to claim exemption? For example, an employee is receiving HRA, but he is resided at his own house. He is not resided at his rented house. In that situation, that exemption is not eligible. Second one. He is resided in a rented house, but he didn't pay any rent during the previous year. Here also he is not eligible to claim exemption under section 10 subsection 13A. I mean, any employee who is receiving HRA, if he want to claim exemption under section 10 subsection 13A, he should reside at a residential house which is unrented. And second one, even though he is resided in a rented house, he has to pay rent during the previous year. While calculating the exemption, how much of rent he paid, we have to take into consider. For example, 2000 rupees per month, that should be multiplied by 12. So, 12 into 2000, 24,000. if we pay 24,000, then only we have to take 24,000. Otherwise, how much he paid, that has to be taken. So, this is the condition for the purpose of claiming exemption. Either he may be a government employee, non-government employee, or any statutory body employee or local authority employee. So, that is the condition. I told in the beginning, 40% of salary, 50% of salary, 10% of salary. Then what do you mean by salary for this purpose? In general, salary means basic DA, DP, commission, or any other bonus, perquisites, so on. But while calculating the exemption for HRA purpose, salary means certain informations are there, should keep it in mind. Then what is salary? Salary means basic plus DA, that is dearness allowance, and DP, that is dearness payment, and commission based on fixed percentage of turnover which is achieved by a particular employee. If he is receiving these salary, then only it should be included. Otherwise, it should not be included. For example, an employee receiving basic only DA. He is not receiving the dearness payment, it should not be included. He is not receiving any commission, should not be included. If he is receiving salary basic plus DA, that is dearness allowance, plus dearness payment, if commission is earned, certain percentage on turnover, that should be included. Otherwise, should not be included. Then what should not be included in the salary? Bonus should not be included in the salary, allowances should not be included in the salary, or any other perquisites should not include in the salary. It should be included for tax care purpose, but for an exemption purpose, salary means only basic plus dearness allowance plus dearness payment and commission on certain percentage of turnover. And second one, suppose if for dearness allowance and dearness payment is included, but it should be a part of retirement benefit. At the time of employment, the employer gives certain information, what are the emoluments should be included as a retirement benefit. So, if it is included as a retirement benefit or considered for a retirement benefit, then only we have to consider as a salary, otherwise should not. For example, salary, of course, basic salary 10,000, dearness pay monthly rupees 2,000. At the time of employment, there is a provision like out of this 2000 rupees DA, only 1000 rupees is considered for retirement benefit, and here salary means basic plus out of 2000 rupees DA, we have to take only 1000 because only 1000 is considered for retirement benefit. In simple, if you want to consider as a salary for house rent allowances exemption, it should be included in the retirement benefits. So, this is what do you mean by salary? Students, this is section 10, subsection 13A, which is related to house rent allowances. In different cases, we have to consider salary and any other things. We have to go with some examples. So, right now, we have to understand what is the concept, what is the provision under section 10, subsection 13A, and how it is affected, to whom it is eligible and to whom it is not eligible, and what is the salary means. So, in the next class, we have to discuss about how it is calculated through an example. Thank you.